right now.
It's 7 a.m. from Fox 35. This is Good Day.
Coming up, but right now, thousands of you might be struggling to make your mortgage payments, but a new program is getting ready to roll out, and it could mean some big help for you. Here with us now, foreclosure attorney Matt Englert. Matt, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Tell about this program, Florida's Hardest Hit Fund. First of all, why was it set up?
Well, there's a $1 billion allocated for the state of Florida, and I have to say in the beginning of the segment that Florida could have done a much better job in allocating this money to actually help people. In my mind, this is just one big giveaway for the banks. What the program does is that if you're unemployed,
okay,
and you're not more than 6 months behind on your mortgage, and there's a whole list of other things you have to meet in order to qualify for it, the state will come in and actually subsidize your mortgage payment.
How much?
Up to $12,000 per person.
Okay, so you have to be unemployed though.
Have to be unemployed or underemployed. Your mortgage payment cannot exceed 31% of your gross income. So as long as you meet that certain criteria, the state will come in and actually make your mortgage payment for you.
Now, why are you saying the banks are making a bunch of money off of this?
Because in most instances, when someone is that far behind and delinquent on their mortgage and they're unemployed, they are not going to find employment to make their mortgage payment, to be able to afford that mortgage payment within 6 months. So essentially, you're giving the bank money that they would not otherwise get before they take the property back in a foreclosure action. What the money should have gone towards is fixing the problem. You know, they could have used that money to help legal aid so these people could get legal representation in order to actually fix the problem. So force the lender to do a loan modification, or at least get them out of it, get the homeowner out of the property, minimize the deficiency, if not eliminate the deficiency, so they can walk away from it and be placed in a living situation they could afford moving forward.
So do you see this program as a band-aid in some ways?
That's all it is a band-aid, and it really is a huge giveaway for the banks, because they're going to get $1 billion of money that they otherwise probably would never get from these homeowners.
Okay, and we're going to have more on this on our website, myfoxorlando.com. If you want to know more about this program. I have to ask you though, what's going on in Central Florida these days? I mean, are we seeing the worst of it when it comes to, with foreclosure, or do we have more foreclosures to go?
We have thousands of foreclosures sitting on the sidelines waiting for the banks to finish this robo-signing thing. So the banks have gone back and now they're trying to fix this whole foreclosure problem. In other words, get all the paperwork and make sure that when they file a foreclosure, they have all the proper documentation. So the filings have gone way down, but there are still thousands of homes out there that have to go through the foreclosure process that haven't even begun.
When people are calling your office, what are they telling you? What are they saying?
The biggest thing is employment. People just don't have enough money to afford the mortgage payment that they may have gotten 3, 4, or 5 years ago, and there's just no good jobs in sight. You know, we've shipped a lot of our jobs overseas, and now the chicken has come home to roost, and there's just no jobs, or there's no good paying jobs. So even if someone does get a job, it's making half of what they used to make. That's the biggest problem, is employment.
And some people might be angry too, because they're doing the right thing, they're paying their mortgage on time, maybe they haven't lost a job, but they still can't get any help from the banks. What would you say to them?
I would say you have to fight with them. You can't let them tell you no. If you think you may qualify for a loan modification and your bank tells you you don't take that answer at face value. Even if you have to, go out and get legal representation. Find a lawyer who understands this area of the law, and it has become very specialized. And go after them and make sure you hold them accountable, because you can force them to do a loan modification so you can stay in your house.
Because you're saying persistence can help?
Absolutely, it helps. You have to be persistent. You have to wear the bank down.
Oh, all right. Well, thank you so much for your tips. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
Foreclosure attorney Matt Englert. Let's send it over to Amy right now.
All right. Thanks so much, you guys. Serious flood concerns this morning over the Red River Valley in North Dakota. Some